The USL Championship is presented by UC Davis Health. Tonight, the Beale Street boys are on the road for the first time this season as they face the indomitable club from Sacramento. The 901 may be coming off a bye week, but will be shorthanded on the back line after two key defenders were issued red cards against Indy 11. Meanwhile, Sacramento back home after a 2 weeks away, and they hope some home cooking will do them some good as well. Welcome inside Heart Health Park. I'm Rob McAllister, and with me as always is former Republic midfielder Adam Moffitt. Well, Adam, Sacramento feeling pretty good about their performances. However, the team feels maybe the results have not been as good.
Sacramento have been in a position through these first three games to get 9 points. They only have 5 to show for it. 2 ties, 1 win. But they have a chance tonight to be at home, get the first 3 points of the season at home. They got 11 wins, 33 points from victories here at home. They'll be looking to get this man, Trevor Ammon, involved. Get off to a fast start tonight against a good side in Memphis.
Meanwhile, for the 901, a lot of changes in the offseason, losing some key pieces. They're hoping to bounce back after a week away.
2-1 win, 2-1 loss. So for them, it's a tough game. And you mentioned it earlier, 2 key red cards in the last game, their fullbacks. There's going to be some adjustments made. That's maybe an area Sacramento can exploit of Memphis tonight.
Will it be some young players like Knight Pickering? Will it be some veterans like Nico Brett? Hard to say for Memphis, but for Sacramento, a full lineup. This one's going to be a good one. Week 4 in the USL Championship. Kickoff is coming up.
At Sky River Casino, join today and receive $15 in free play. Take your loyalty to new heights with rewards that add up and up. Sky's the limit at Sky River Casino. Join today at skyriver.com.
How do you build a community that thrives? By staying active, by working and playing together, and by building strong bones and bodies with food that's simple, local, and fresh. Crystal Creamery has proudly supported Central Valley athletes and athletic programs since 2012. Because when you nourish a community, the community thrives. Crystal Creamery, simple, local, fresh.
If we can bring new life into the world, why can't we bring new hope to those who need it most? If we can remove cancer, why can't we remove hunger? If we can rebuild bodies, why can't we rebuild entire communities? Better health takes more than healthcare. UC Davis Health. Believe in
experience the height of hospitality. With 18 restaurants and bars, there's something for everyone. It's taste on a whole new level. Sky's the limit at Sky River Casino. Join today at skyriver.com.
A beautiful spring evening in the capital of California, the Republic hosting 901 of Memphis. Last time these two teams got together, a season ago, a 1-1 draw here in Sacramento. Hard to believe. Memphis has been around for 5 years. Republic, of course, 10 plus. So this is only the second meeting all time between these two teams.
And that was a really good game last year as well. And I think we'll see the same tonight. Finished 1-1. Goal scorers with Russell Cicerone. Hindman for Memphis, who is not available tonight. But it's going to be another tough challenge for Sacramento here at home.
Well, speaking of Russell Cicerone, you saw him score in there, leading scorer for the Republic a season ago. Trying to get on the board for the first time this year. However, it's just his third match.
It is just his third match, and obviously he missed the first game of the season. He's hungry to get on the score sheet. You'll see him hustle tonight. But fortunately for Sacramento, Trevor Ammon's been scoring.
Both of them have 10 shots on the year. Meanwhile, this is a team that's going to have to look for some other options in Memphis 901. It's going to be maybe Bruno Lapa getting in the involved. Let's take a look first as we look at the 11 for Sacramento Republic. They'll go in the 3-4-3. Rodrigo Lopez back in the starting lineup. Hasn't been in the lineup since week one. Came off the bench on the road. He will be in the 11 for Mark Bridges' side. Other than that, same 11 for Sacramento moving forward. Let's take a look now at Memphis 901. We talked about a couple of players who might step up. Could it be Bruno Lapa tonight? Had a pretty good season a year ago. 32 matches, 4 goals, 4 assists.
He's a handful. He's got an opportunity tonight to produce. He'll be working with Nico Brett. and Knight Pickering up top. So for him, he's got to get the ball to his feet. He can make things happen that way. It's a dangerous player for Sacramento to keep an eye on.
Let's take a look at the 11-4 in the 901. And this is a lineup, obviously a lot of change. Talked about just the previous segment without their two starting fullbacks. No Keem Ward, no Oscar Jimenez. It means there's going to be some changes here. Will this mean three in the back row? Will we see some changes where Tulu, Derek is obviously going to be the goalkeeper, but Vom Steek, Sissoko, will Turchi be back there? It's kind of be hard to see. Let's see how Steven Glass lines up.
Not only is it the first game on the road, but they're also missing those two players, so there might be a little bit of an adjustment there for Steven Glass and his side, and we'll see as the game unfolds how Memphis will line up.
Nine and one, Republic, week four. Kickoff is coming up next.
At Sky River Casino, catch all the action with rewards that add up and up. Experience new heights. With 18 restaurants, bars, and lounges, there's something for everyone. Enjoy over 80 table games, more than 2,100 slot machines, and our thrilling high-limit room. Savor the win. Sky's the limit at Sky River Casino. Join today at skyriver.com.
If we can bring new life into the world, why can't we bring new hope to those who need it most? If we can remove cancer, why can't we remove hunger? If we can rebuild bodies, why can't we rebuild entire communities? Better health takes more than healthcare. UC Davis Health. Believe in better.
How do you build a community that thrives? By staying active, by working and playing together, and by building strong bones and bodies with food that's simple, local, and fresh. Crystal Creamery has proudly supported Central Valley athletes and athletic programs since 2012. Because when you nourish a community, the community thrives. Crystal Creamery, simple, local, fresh.
Are you ready to join the charge and put down the pump? If you're ready for a clean start, contact Smut first. We'll help you find ways to save, share the best options to charge at home or on the go, and answer any questions you have about owning an electric vehicle. For everything you need to know about buying, charging, saving, and low rates, start here. Contact Smud first at smud.org/driveelectric.
Tonight's broadcast is brought to you in part by UC Davis Health, Western Health Advantage, and Sky River Casino. -56 degrees. The Tower Bridge Battalion is ready. The other 9,000 plus here at Hartwell Park ready to go. Bruno Lapa and the 901 all in white. The Republic in red. They'll head to the south where there's a 10-mile-an-hour breeze headed toward the Sacramento River just below us here as the Republic fans ready to see this team pull out 3 points tonight. But they got a tough task. This is a team, while a lot of changes in the offseason, this is a club that's got some firepower up top. Knight Pickering, Nico Brett, very good. And Adam, you look at this type of game, and for Sacramento, very easy to say, you know what, this could be an easy 3 points for us because of some of the missing pieces for Memphis 901.
Yeah, you never want to be too complacent. As Republic get underway, and straight away they're going to send it forward. Look to get the second ball.
This will come quickly to Tyler Derrick out of Spring, Texas. Former teammate of Adam Moffitt, 95 appearances with RGV, a couple of seasons, but really made a name for himself in MLS with the Houston Dynamo. Take a look at our inactive report brought to you by Delta Dental, and a couple of names for both teams here as we begin with Sacramento. No Sebastian Herrera, Arnold Lopez, Davian Kimbrough. not going to be available. Meanwhile, we talked about the red cards. Akeem Ward and Oscar Jimenez for Memphis 901 not going to be in the 18, as well as sort of a surprise. We weren't really quite believe that we'd see this, but no Hindman here. It's a big piece. Scored a goal here a year ago against Sacramento in the 1-1 draw.
See early. Turchi's going to be in this left. It looks like they are going with four at the back, Memphis. Turchi on the left, Vom Stieg on the right. You have Sissoko and Tulu as the center backs. It's going to be a big job for Turchi, Vom Stieg, replacing Jimenez. Akeem Ward getting up and down the field.
Memphis team 3 points on the year. Started with a home victory in the opening weekend against Las Vegas 2-1, and then falling to Indy 11 a week later. Off last week. Meanwhile, here's a ball played centrally into the box, and it'll be cleared by Nick Ross. Lucas Turchi out of Brazil, third season with Memphis, one of the longest members of this Memphis side. Early in, here comes Fernando playing essentially an opportunity, and it's denied by the Republic, and it appears to be Alder Sanchez, who just got enough in there. But early on, you can see Luis Fernando, Zachary Duncan, Leston Paul really starting to bunch up in the middle there and try to get an early goal.
A really good opportunity for Memphis to get a snatch goal early. Nico Brett down this left-hand side. He's just so powerful, hard to knock over. And he cuts it back, and that was well defended, and end up from Sacramento getting a body in front of it. A little wake-up call.
Sacramento a little bit off here to start. A little shaky for the home side. We're on the road two straight weeks. Went to Miami, got a 1-0 victory, and then a 1-1 draw with Indy 11 a weekend ago. Here's Rodrigo Lopez, a little bit of room just outside the 18. Tried to play it wide. Cicerone was angling in, and Jack Gurr keeps it in play. Miscommunication from both sides. Here's Bruno Lapa, he's got the step. Nico Brett to his right, he'll play it left to Fernando. Fernando, and his opportunity will come high and wide. Nico Brett in front. Nick Ross is able to get there. That ball hanging up just a little bit. Maybe the wind keeping that one in play. Here's the one thing we'll know about Memphis. This is probably not a team that's just going to sit back and wait. They're going to go after and try to get this game here. And we're seeing it early. Both teams not settled in. And it feels a little shaky and really uncharacteristic of both teams.
Really positive start for Memphis. You saw some claims for handball. I think it was Pickering at the back post. Tried to put it across the face of goal, maybe at the hand of Lee Desmond. Those are always interesting. It's always tough to judge what is a handball, what isn't these days. The referee deemed it wasn't, but really bright start for Memphis. And if you're Sacramento, you got to start building your way into this game. And you can see they're doing it going side to side, keeping that ball. Something Mark Briggs has wanted them to do more this year.
Well, three games in, we've seen the possession numbers really tick up for Sacramento compared to a season ago. This is a direct ball into the corner and a bit too heavy.
Through three games for the Republic this season, what's always interesting to see is how a team likes to play building out from the goalkeeper. We've seen some direct play where they just send everyone forward, kick it long. We've seen teams like Miami who get the defenders, and you can see Memphis and thinking about it here, and they just send them up the field. Sometimes when you're on the road, you just don't want to, you don't want to make any mistakes early. So just opting to send that ball high up the field.
Connor Donovan, nearly two-headed goals against Memphis a season ago here. It was a late goal by Russell Cicerone to earn the point for the Republic. Eric Hyman in the second half as well, getting a goal. Take the lead for Memphis, but it would not hold. And now the second meeting all tie between these two teams. 5 points on the year for Sacramento. An opening weekend matchup with Orange County ended 2-2 after two set-piece goals by the visiting club. Here's a turnover right to Rodrigo Lopez. Alder Sanchez getting his third consecutive start. Nambi Villadaire back on the bench after 2 weeks away. Did get the start in week one. Memphis 9-1 without Akeem Ward and Oscar Jimenez. Interesting to see because they really rely on those two fullbacks to get in to produce a bit of their attack. Now, will we see more of this tonight? Will Turchie get into the attack? Will he stay home? Sometimes when you have missing pieces, it allows you to do something different that your opponent may be not ready for it.
I believe that earlier opportunity for Memphis, the one that was blocked in the box, was actually Von Stieg, who made his way all the way up there. So I think we will see them get up and down the field, add that extra dimension when they need it.
Lee Desmond all the way into Memphis' side of the park, and here comes Turchie. Turchie trying to play a direct ball, looking for Nico Brett, and what a striker he has been over his USL Championship career. Third all-time, 86 goals, 200-plus appearances, 12 goals, 4 assists in Birmingham a season ago. So he adds quite a bit of punch at top after this, a team who lost Aaron Malloy, Graham Smith, Rodrigo da Costa. Now the bit of rest early on. Probably pretty rough to have an early bye this early in the season. Just 2 games in and you're already getting that rest. A little bit of contact, no whistle coming from our referee, Ahilio Araguin, tonight. Knight Pickering getting a couple of touches there, fresh off a U.S. new national team call-up, U19s. Away for 10 days, but it worked out perfectly for Memphis as they did not have a game during that stretch. Here comes Fernando angling in, battling with Timmer. They'll play it centrally, goes a little bit through and soft, and Rodrigo Lopez will find it. Ross to Cicerone. Cicerone looks over his shoulder, cuts back in. Now he's going to charge forward, continues his dribble, trying to find Ammon, comes back to Nick Ross, who plays it out to Gurr. Gurr with a step. Hesitation, cross all the way to Roro. Roro takes it off his chest, looking for a teammate. Here comes Sacramento, and it's cleared away by Sissoko. What a buildup from the Republic there. Patience in nearly finding a goal at the end of it, and almost with the captain with his first assist on the season.
Yeah, initially starts with Russell Cicerone picking it up, driving into space. Doesn't work out, but Nick Ross keeps it alive, gets it to Jack Gurr. Rodrigo Lopez inches away from getting that back to Jack Gurr. And they do have a corner kick, Sacramento. And again, that's just Russell Cicerone picking the ball up, finding little pockets in between the midfielders and defenders, and the awareness to get turned, get run into people.
There's our Atlas disposal, first corner kick of the evening, quickly to Rodrigo Lopez. Roro gonna play it, there's some space for Gurr. Gurr will take a crack at it. Just angling in, too many bodies in the six, and it will be a goal kick for Tyler Derrick.
It's a well-rehearsed corner kick there. I'm not sure if it worked exactly as they planned, but Jack Gurr just snatches at it. Body's coming at it, drags it past the near post.
Here's Mark Briggs, fifth season. 61 wins, 36 losses, and 38 draws all time. The longest tenured Republic coach. Of course, has had quite a run here the last couple of seasons, taking the club to the U.S. Open Cup finale against Orlando City of MLS in Florida. And then the number one seed in the Western Conference a season ago that ended with a defeat to Phoenix in the Western Conference finale. A start for Sacramento. Well, before you start digging, it's crucial to contact 811. The free service allows utility companies to mark their underground lines, helping to protect the community from risk and utility line damages. Call 811 before you dig. This one sent deep. Tyler Derrick will go to the ground as Aldair Sanchez making the run.
A nice idea from Jack Gurr. The wind maybe took it a little bit closer to Tyler Derrick. He was confident coming out and snatching the ball. And again, just sending his defenders up. Not wanting to take any risks on the road, Memphis. They know how hard it is to score against Sacramento Republic. If you give up a goal early, it might be tough. Unless you send your goalkeeper up in the last minute, hopefully. Don't see that again. That is
Colin Shuttler, the third goalkeeper in the last 15 years of the USL Championship to get a goal, and he did it in the 96-plus minute, I think it was. to tie 2-2 in opening weekend here against Orange County.
I did play in one game where a goalkeeper did score. It was 2008, I believe. My teammate scored up in Toronto, Will Hesmer. We tied the game, and it was,
and what it was
a fun time.
What a lift that is. I'm sure the locker room, and here's a bit of extracurricular activity between Zach Duncan and Rodrigo Lopez.
And 2 weeks after that, he got red carded. We see a lot of foul coming in. He got red carded, so one of our strikers goes in goals. He got save of the week, and the other player got goal of the week. So the goalkeeper goal of the week, or striker save of the week.
Versatility is what you want on the team, right?
And not too much here. A little shoving. Zach Duncan going on a little bit easy.
Former top prospect out of Australia. I love what they've seen from him so far. This youngster, really a great box-to-box central midfielder for Memphis 901. He's been a great surprise in terms of his ability to step right in and perform. Probably exactly what they were hoping for when they signed number 6, especially with some of the key losses Memphis 901 endured over the offseason. And now that they're in the Western Conference, Republic will travel to Tennessee later this year. Cicerone's got a little bit of room here. He's going to play it forward. It's denied by Sissoko. Connor Donovan battling with Brett. And with Nico Brett in there, it seems that Pickering's playing a little bit out wider to the right compared to what he did in the first couple of matches for this Memphis squad.
Well, you see from Memphis, it might be a 4-1-4-1. 4-2-3-1, but Knight Pickering starts on that right. That's a great challenge from Nick Ross, and that's going to lead the attack. So Cicerone's on his bike.
Turchi getting there, just a bit of size, maybe a little bit bigger, and Nick Ross is taken down, and there will be a heavy challenge from Zach Duncan, and out comes the game's first booking as Elio Aragon said it was a bit too much from number 6, and it'll be Sacramento on a set piece here in the 13th.
Just unaware Nick Ross is coming in behind him. Good alert. Piece of midfield in by Nick Ross. Just getting there first. Zach Duncan. There's no option. Just gets his leg out straight. I don't really know if he knew too much about it, but he's something he has to be aware of now the remainder of the game. You're 13 minutes in as a center mid who likes to get around. You get your yellow card. That was always something I hated as a midfielder, getting the yellow card in the first half. It definitely does change how you play a little bit.
Rodrigo Lopez directing traffic here. A little bit into the breeze, not too much of a wind. This one's lofted perfectly, looking for an opportunity. Trevor Hammond, almost number 4 on the season. The away bleachers there on the other end of the stadium thought that one may have gone by Tyler Derrick, but what a breakout start. Tyler Derrick nearly getting his league leading 4th.
The net.
Meanwhile, a turnover here, live action, as Cicerone trying to play to Gurr, and Gurr is just a step offside. That was awfully close. Good heads up play from Russell Cicerone.
Sacramento straight away. Memphis tries to play it short, and I'm not sure if they're going to do it again here. They might just opt to send players forward. Jack Kerr slightly offside.
Well, what are you waiting for? 2 weeks already in the books here at home. Season ticket members, they've been enjoying the benefits. Now you can too. Head over to sacrepublicfc.com/memberships. Discover how you can be a part of the excitement here in 2024 as Republic look to repeat as Western Conference champions. Start off the season unbeaten, just as they did a year ago. And it was in week 4 they took on Luce City, the powerhouse out of the Eastern Conference, and a 5-0 drubbing here at Heart Health Park. And it was a statement match, to say the least. Trevor Ammon, 3 out of 4 games, he's nearly had his jersey ripped off. It's almost like it's in the scouting book, and there's 2 yellows already. Left back Turchi, the other is Zach Duncan. What's going on with Trevor Ammon? His jersey there.
Something about that jersey. Everyone wants it. I don't know if the kit man would be too happy. Could be another rip on there. Good persistence, though, from Trevor Ammon. We speak about the goals that he scored, but he's got a good work rate up top. A lot of the time, he's a little bit isolated up there.
Yeah. And these are kind of key moments, Adam, is that this is a little bit of frustration maybe early, maybe out of position, and now you've gotten yourself in a little bit of a situation if you're Memphis here, because you don't have a deep bench tonight. Just four outfield players. Right. Two goalkeepers on the bench.
Rodrigo Lopez here, he's going to try and put it between the defenders and Tyler Derrick. But he really needs someone running across the front post.
Ammon and Leston Paul get a little bit shoving, and now they'll get a talking to by Helio Aragüen.
Just keep an eye on Jack Gurr as well. He's just at the top of the box. Doesn't look like he's involved, but if the defenders start dropping, he could come in here late.
Crowd stomping their feet on the metal bleachers. Rodrigo Lopez servicing this one in. It'll fall into place, but to the feet of Memphis 901, and Sacramento looks to recover the possession. Aldair Sanchez sliding through, nail making the run. He's on the other side of the pitch, leaving the left side open. Jack Gurr and Rodrigo Lopez will slow it down for Sacramento to retain. Lee Desmond working around Knight Pickering. Felipe, here comes the service. Cicerone trying to get a turn on it. Defended well enough. Aldair Sanchez, the continued hustle by the Sacramento Republic, causing a little bit of problems here, and Tyler Derrick sliding out of his six to make the play. No score, 17 plus minutes in here in Sacramento.
17 minutes in, and first 7 minutes or so, Memphis started really brightly. Had a couple of opportunities in the attack, and we haven't seen much since then. Sacramento has been able to keep the ball, move it around.
Felipe, a bit outstretched, hustling as Cicerone near the touchline, able to recover. Sacramento's threat not done yet. Sanchez playing it forward just in time for Ammon on the arrival, and it skirts through. And Memphis catching a break. Crowd ready to erupt here in Sacramento. Looking for the game's first. Republic starting to show much better patience and ball control here. Cicerone on the corner, trying to shrug off a defender. Will get back to his left against Pickering. Little give and go here, and too many white jerseys. Here comes Nick Ross. Oh, the follow-up is denied.
Memphis struggling to get the ball out here.
Here's Gurr, got a step. Leston Paul able to make a play. And Fernando goes down.
And they'll be happy that that relieves some of the pressure they're under. It was just waves of attack there from Sacramento from one side to the other side.
So A.B. Sissoko taking a break here in observance of Ramadan. Well, Republic FC matches are the perfect place to make lifelong memories with your friends and family. Groups of 10 or more can enjoy discounted seating, access to exclusive fan experiences, and much more. SacRepublicFC.com. Group tickets for more information on how to reserve your next group outing. This may be one of the final cooler nights we have in Sacramento, and it's still mid-50s, and this is not... But we saw in Indy a week ago where the temperatures were in the 40s for the Sacramento Republic. Republic 64 points a season ago. Memphis with 52. Fourth place in the East. They go 14-10-10. In the postseason, they lose to Lou City on penalty kicks. Now they switch over to the West. And regardless if you argue whether the West is deeper this year versus the East because of some of the changes in the teams and added and dropped out, the travel to me is probably the biggest hill this team is going to have to climb this year. They're traveling more than anybody in their own conference.
It is. I mean, you look at a map, I don't know if you've ever looked at one, but here they are.
Where would you find such a thing?
Yes, they have on the phones now. They have these, but they are far away, and you know, either way from Memphis, you're probably having connect them flights, but it does add up when you're going there. I've played in some of those smaller markets, and the travel is not great, but it's just something when you're playing here in the U.S. you do get used to.
Well, I guess for Memphis, the East Coast trips are a little bit easier than maybe Republic, Orange County, Monterey Bay have to contend with.
You know what? The frequent flyer miles we get will be well worth it.
Well worth
you
it.
Get that, book that flight to Hawaii for free.
Well, Nick Ross was a little upset last year because of his injury. He only had 23 flights on Southwest, so he actually missed the two to get to A-list preferred, and it said it was one of his biggest disappointments of 2023.
Well, gotta stay healthy. Here comes Nico Brett once again.
Brett playing this one, and it'll curling ball looking for Pickering. Aldair Sanchez able to cut it off in time, but here comes pressure still from Memphis 901. Good play here from Sacramento to get this out of their danger zone. Yellow will take a and try to play it back to a teammate, Jacker. I think Memphis 901 thought that would just be played out. Meanwhile, they get the turnover anyway. Lapa spreading across the field, getting to the right side. Carson Von Stiga to Santa Barbara. The cross coming in, opportunity as Duncan went up in the air.
A lot of bodies in the box for Memphis on that attack. Von Stiga puts a little too much on it. No one at the back post. Now Sacramento's return to attack. Well, they've done a good job here is going from right to left. If it's not on, they'll get it out the other side. There was an acres of space for Aldair Sanchez. Garrett was able to find them there.
Roro, the nice poke free from behind. Christian Pirano was questionable for this game. He is in the 18 after starting the first three matches for Sacramento.
This is where Sacramento's done a better job this year. We speak about the performance. There's only 5 points through the first three games. We say only, I think it's a bad thing. It's great to get those points undefeated still, but as we mentioned earlier, they were in position to potentially get nine. But what they're doing is just being patient, going side to side, waiting for the right moments, and this might be one here.
Lopez cutting back. A lot more interchanging happening with the wingers as well. You don't just see it through the middle part with Felipe and Roro and Ross. It's Jacker and others as well, as this one's played a little too heavy from Jared Timmer.
And you'll see with Rodrigo Lopez in the game, with Roro in there, there is more interchange. He has the freedom to roam, find where the game is. Sometimes he'll be out of it, and then all of a sudden he pops up. So it's just communication with other players, Cicerone, Nick Ross, Luis Felipe, if they're in there, just making sure that, yes, he can go somewhere, but he's got to be talking to everyone else, and always makes it trickier when you don't really know who's where.
Tulu, a lot of experience back there as a center back, more than 60 appearances in the USL. Him from San Antonio, played some critical matches for them. A little quick tap from Roto looking for Ammon, and this ball will be sent out of play by Tyler Derrick. Memphis led again by Stephen Glass, who this man Jacker played for in Atlanta and then followed him to Scotland, took over the MLS side for a bit on interim role.
Doing the game with Jack last year, he was so complimentary of Stephen Glass and his coaching. I'm sure they're glad to be reunited tonight, although both want different results.
Cicerone's got a little space here. He's got Ammon to his left, as is Roro. A little bit too soft for Jacker and easy enough for Torchy to clear. A quick throw in, Nick Ross. It's 2 weeks in a row we've really seen teams go out and try to win the game, and a foul is whistled against Memphis. Compare that to the Miami game where it was basically six in the 18 almost the entire evening. We really saw Indy get after it. This Memphis side doing the same on the road, which we've experienced quite a bit here, is if teams get aggressive that first 15, 20 minutes, try to get early score, then they just basically try to park the bus the rest of the way. Memphis looks like they're going to come out and try to win one here tonight. I guess they know that points here are very valuable, and if you can get three, that could go a long way finding yourself in the postseason 30 weeks from now.
Sacramento has looked dangerous on these set pieces, and it's another opportunity for Roro here. This one is, it's a couple of yards closer to the goal, and there's a wind going into Tyler Derrick here. Not sure if he'll go for the shot. He found Trevor Ammon last time.
They found Connor Donovan, but unable to get a clean purchase on it.
Checker's going to keep that in. He knows all those defenders are back from Memphis, so quickly get the ball back in play. Don't let them get up the field.
First road game of the 2024 season for Memphis. This one will bounce into some space for Jacker. He's in the corner trying to turn. The throw in will come as Sissoko played it out. Little give, now a go. Here's Gurr, cleared away. Corner kick coming. It'll be Rodrigo Lopez.
Sacramento still having really trouble. Tyler Derrick. We've seen Trevor Ammon almost getting the end of a cross from the left-hand side, and then putting a header just wide of the post. I haven't forced the goalkeeper into too many saves as of yet.
Rodrigo Lopez redirecting Nick Ross closer to the corner here. Roro will send it right to number 19. He'll send it right back. Beyond the six it goes. Here's Alder Sanchez dribbling. Connor Donovan tried to make a turn on it. Just got caught underneath his feet, and a tackle here by Nick Ross. Just saved a counter coming from Memphis. The way Rodrigo Lopez looks again this year, 36 years of age, and what he did to come back last year, missed 5 months of the season with a hip injury, ended up with 5 assists anyway, and was critical toward the end, but they're hoping to keep him healthy for 34 games this season. How will they monitor his minutes? It's going to be something to keep an eye on. Came off the bench the last 2 weeks, and instantly you could see when number 8 comes into the game, there's a change of pace. There's a calmness to it that really is valuable to Sacramento. And at home, I think we'll probably see more starts from Rodrigo Lopez and maybe more minutes with that as well.
From this right-hand side here, Sacramento, Jack Gers, a throw-in. Going to try and find a way to get that ball from here all the way out to Alder Sanchez on the other side.
Trevor Ammon keeps working. He's got Cicerone to his right. Memphis able to get back, and Cicerone will take his time. Lee Desmond has room. Desmond stepping up, and nearly a takeaway from Zachary Duncan, and now a pressure trying to force Nick Ross into a bad decision. Doesn't happen very often. He has been as good as ever. And here comes Memphis once again, Adam. That pressure starting to build. They're picking their spots. And Tulu sends it clear. Crystal Creamery has been building strong bones and bodies with the freshest dairy from the Central Valley since 1901. Taking pride in delivering dairy you can trust. Grab a glass, taste how fresh local can be. Simple, local, fresh.
coming down the sides for the Republic. Between Sanchez on the left, Gar on the right. Not too much through the middle so far. We haven't seen Trevor Ammon going over the top and running onto anything, but.
What a direct ball here coming. Gar just takes a bit of a hop. Good look for an opportunity to spread out the pitch a bit for Sacramento.
It's always tough to judge as soon as it skips. It's a little bit too short to go and meet it. Tyler Derrick's going to get a little treatment here.
Well, there's two goalkeepers on the bench, I guess, for.
Put both of them in.
Yes, you have options. I mean, obviously you don't want to lose your number one.
No, and he got a little bit of treatment. He was grabbing at that when we took the break in the 19th minute. It's not looking great for him. He's holding the back of his right leg. I think it's his hamstring. Just speaking in code to the trainer. Doesn't want to give anything away.
It's hard not to see what's happening here, right on the hamstring. How about
it's the right hamstring.
Yeah. Well, how about, you know, talk about a guy maybe not available tonight, but really having a start of a year because just the attention he's getting now. He's with the youth 16 team with Mexico. Davian Kimbrough, just 14 years of age. Of course, we saw what he could do. 4 goals and assist in December on the U15 squad. I mean, these are some of the best youngsters in the world, and he's having a state. Now, we haven't really been an opportunity to see in a Sacramento uniform. So hopefully in a couple of weeks, we'll have Davian Kimbrough potentially back in the 18. And we'll add some depth for Sacramento. But the reason he is once again not available. They'll reset the throw. And Turchi commits the foul, and I'll tell you what, you see the warning from Elgilio Aragon. Turchi's already has a booking. He's going to have to be a bit careful now. I don't think that warrants one by any means.
It doesn't, but it puts a little attention on you, and the opposition are aware of that. So the next time he makes a foul, he'll. The public players will make sure they let the referee know that's been a couple. Just has to be careful.
Well, you've seen Luis Fernando drop a little bit and take on Gurr. Now here's Ammon.
I mean, the last thing this Memphis side needs is another fullback getting a red card, so.
Ammon running out of options here. Jack Gurr slipping and falling. And Ammon commits the foul to prevent Memphis from moving forward.
Luis Fernando's looked lively on this left-hand side for Memphis. The few times he's been able to get it. The game's definitely shifted from that opening 5-10 minutes. Memphis unable to really maintain possession higher up the field. And as you see these long balls, it's always tough when Nico Brett's not the tallest. He's a stocky fella. He just can't hold that ball up top.
Comes to Lapa. Here's Paul. The first signings for Memphis. There's Turchi once again. They'll play another direct ball. Looks like Memphis may be trying to go a little bit more direct here in the last few moments. See if they can spring Pickering or Brett. Will find Cicerone checking over his left shoulder. There's some space, and Memphis has defended Sacramento fairly well tonight. There's an opportunity. Ammon trying to just keep the attack moving. And one thing we've seen with Trevor Ammon in the first several weeks here this season, kind of hangs around. He makes his runs, and then boom, he's able to find a goal seemingly out of nowhere. Found two on opening night and leads the league with three. Here's Cicerone, a little too heavy of a touch.
No longer leading the league. We've got a new Wilson Harris.
Well, that's
just
right.
Got two
right.
today, so he's up there before. So maybe Trevor Hammond saw that.
He's ready to go.
I've never been in that kind of position. Yeah, it's like I'm worrying about who's going to be the golden boots scorer. Yellow cards was always my, if I can get more yellow cards than other players.
Especially with
Jack Kerr just coming up late on this right hand side, and we know Rodrigo Lopez can spray it.
Nick Ross.
The quicker you can get it out, the more time and space you give it to Jack. That's the difference right there. You saw it took Sacramento three passes to get it to Jack. By the time it gets to him, the space is closed down. So they are doing the right thing and being patient. But if you can get that first time ball over, you give him enough time and space to be facing forward. That's a great run by Sanchez.
Alder looking for Ammon. Defensively, Turchi, though, a bit better and able to block Trevor out of the play. Slipping and falling is Fernando. Now it's Luis moving forward. Gurr's going to send this, and it's deflected by Turchi again. Three runners, and a fourth was Sanchez on the backside, all ready to receive that from Jack Gurr. And Turchi does everything he can to deny. Fernando, pretty good season a year ago for Memphis. 8 goals, 5 assists. Sort of a lurking threat for the 901 on this left wing.
They have the balls. 4-1-2-3, it looks like, for Memphis. Without it, it's 4-1-4-1. Those wider players, Knight Pickering, who's actually moved a little more central, closer to Lee Desmond. He's not staying as wide. He's letting Von Stee come up and take that space. And that's just something to keep an eye on. He scored a fantastic goal in week one. Left foot, here he is against Lee Desmond.
That's the kind of opportunity you can see Memphis is trying to create now. Maybe they find that that's where they've had success. You saw Augustine Williams able to turn Connor Donovan and get a game tying goal a week ago in Indianapolis. Well, choosing the right health plan for you and your family is simple with Western Health Advantage. Check out their affordable plans that have been keeping the community strong for more than 25 years. Go online, westernhealth.com. Cicerone playing quite deep, especially with Trevor Ammon now in the 11. Rodrigo Lopez trying to draw a foul and does. And Turchi is going to be on notice. And you're going to see another conversation taking place between referee Ejelio Araguin and Lucas Turchi, who is sitting on that booking the first 15 minutes of this game. And now that's two warnings here, Adam.
Yeah, and I've been in this situation as a player before where you're on the yellow card. I would be surprised if we saw him in the second half. There's just too much at stake. I believe that was the final warning from the referee, unless it was the final warning.
Final.
But I think that might be it. One more foul from Lucas Turchi. It might not even need to be a bad foul, but he could be walking. So Stephen Glass is going to be having to make a big decision here.
Well, that may alter the formation. I mean, you look at the bench here and
you put a goalkeeper at left back.
Yeah, I don't know who you're putting back there. Unless you start to shift some players around. Little tap. Gurr's got a step. Gurr able to take the deflection. It's still in play for Sacramento. And now cleared by Memphis.
You see Pickering, he's hanging out higher up the field, and this is a great chance for Memphis to hit the Republic on the counter.
Nico Brett sliding through. To the left side it comes Lapa. Fernando now. Paul will play it in. A little bit of contact. Memphis was hoping to maybe pick up a penalty. Won't get it. This ball is going to find right to Trevor Ammon, who's stride. Doesn't have numbers. We'll have to peel back. Gurr's in support, as is Cicerone. They'll switch the field to Sanchez. Alder inside the 18. Alder to his left. Too many bodies allowed Memphis to recover here. Nick Ross may go for goal. Nick Ross nearly bending one. He's got to move quicker there. I think there was an opportunity for Sacramento to strike, and they just maybe got a little too patient.
Yeah, not a bad effort from Nick Ross, but Sacramento's settling for a shot from 25 yards up. And he does well with it, and then Alder Sanchez just caught in two minds, whether to take the shot himself, whether to pass it. And that results in, again, as an effort. It had Tyler Derrick scrambling. That looked like that was the first time Memphis in a while had committed a lot of bodies forward and opened things up for Sacramento. They were able to go down the other end. And Tyler Derrick, I think his night is done.
That's brutal change for Stephen Glass in this Memphis side, as their number one is going to be unable to continue his third appearance of the season. And Tyler Derrick will come out. Marlon Santos, however, is also coming to the fourth official here and getting ready. So not quite sure what this change will be.
Yeah. You thought because they have two goalkeepers in the bet, they're going to put Santos in goal.
Oh, Lucas Turchi. So you know what? Not only do we might see a change here for Memphis in the goalkeeper position, but in the field as well. So Marlon Santos in, listed as a forward, and he's one who's typically played in that position. So you're wondering if maybe Lapa will step back and you'll see some movement, maybe Leston Paul on the left side, or they go three in the back here. We'll have to see what they do. Meanwhile, there will be a goalkeeper change here. It looks like Taylor Bailey is going to come into the match.
Yeah, and it's unfortunate for Turchi. Wasn't having a bad game, but I don't think Stephen Glass wants to wait any longer. Just a couple minutes back, it was Trevor Ammon was one-on-one with him, and one more foul and he was out of the game. And it's always tough as a player to be in that spot, but I think it's the right decision by the coach. It's not worth waiting two more minutes and running that risk. As we see Santos is...
So Soko will go out to the left. You'll see Tulu and Vom Stieg, and then Santos looks to be maybe the winger or right back. See where they settle in here. You could see Leston Paul. So I'm not quite sure what Stephen Glass has in mind here, Adam, but either way, two changes he probably didn't think he was going to have to make in the 42nd minute. Couldn't even get to the locker room. Pretty brutal.
Yeah, and Tyler Derrick is still in the game, not out yet. Bailey is ready, and we're hearing that change will happen, probably more so at halftime.
He checked in, but did not fully come into the game. Meanwhile, Paul and company trying to get something going, and a foul is committed. Paul stumbling a bit. Luis Felipe said he didn't touch him. And the referee says otherwise, and a set piece here for Memphis 901. And you're right, it looks like Taylor Bailey will wait until halftime to come in.
Memphis, a couple of nice interchanges in the midfield. Leston Paul doesn't get forward too much. He's the one that likes to sit back, but he puts Luis Felipe in a tough spot, brings him down from behind, and now you've got the opportunity. You're Memphis, you've sent a couple of the big boys up from the back. You've got Tulu, and especially Sissoko.
Sissoko already a goal, scored against Indy 2 weeks ago. We've seen Pickering get up a bit.
The one thing you will see from this position that Zach Duncan is over the ball, it's a bit straight on. Sometimes these are tough. You're just looking for someone to redirect it and bring it back across goal. And if you don't get the angle right, the goalkeeper just snatches it out there like that.
5 minutes of stoppage time here in the first half of play in Sacramento. Both teams have had some opportunities, but not able to really break through and cause some real threats. And we had a substitution with Marlon Santos. This one goes back to Derrick. And every time you see something go back to Tyler Derrick, you think maybe it'll hold on. Looks like he'll be all right. Make it at least to the locker room and maybe continue after all. Timmer is able to collect this ball, but coming together is Duncan and Felipe, and both holding their shins.
So that right foot of Luis Felipe, he's the one that the foul was called against. Both Duncan and Felipe going to the ground. Thankfully, both of them able to continue, and I think looked a little bit worse than it was. Felipe will get a yellow card for it. He did come in late.
First yellow card for Sacramento.
And it was a tough one because Zach Duncan took a heavy touch and Luis Felipe came in. There was no malice there. He's doing his job. One of the best ball winning midfielders the league, I'd say the league has seen. You know, the amount of duels that guy wins.
Former San Jose Earthquake and Reno 1868. Midfielder, 7 goals, 2 assists a season ago for Sacramento with Luis Felipe having a breakout year and hoping to do more of the same in 2024. Sissoko able to get a step on it. Nick Ross and Fernando able to keep it in play. Central it goes to Paul. Rodrigo Lopez surveying the field. Going to play it over the top to Ammon. A little back heel, and Ammon can't stay on his feet. Sissoko showing a bit of skill back there.
Yeah, go-go gadget leg on that first one. He managed to get it, and then a little nutmeg on the other play. And what we'll see from Memphis, I don't think they'll stick with the back four. We won't see Sissoko fully at left back. Santos might have to defend a little bit more, but he's going to be more of a wing back. We'll put more wing forward maybe, but Sacramento, that's an area they could exploit with the back three. They'll be a little bit narrower. And that could create chances for Jack Gurr because Fernando doesn't want to be tracking back the whole time. He loves going forward.
Well, ball played forward from the back and trying to spring Nico Brett. Yellow floating this one. Sacramento trying to stay sharp here to end the half. No score between Memphis and Sacramento here in Northern California. Sacramento with about 60% of the possession here in the first half.
This is where Jack Gurr's got acres of space and Cicerone's unable to see it.
A heavy challenge coming from the back. Meanwhile, a foul maybe earlier.
Yeah, I think advantage was maybe played and didn't work out. The ball will be Memphis's as we're in the 49th minute. Almost a minute till halftime here. That was a very heavy foul from Lee Desmond. Very heavy challenge, I'll say. It's not a foul.
No shots on target for either side here. Each team maybe seeing if they can sneak one late before the whistle blows. Lapa plays it centrally, turning is Pickering. Bomb Steak back to Pickering. Another takeaway in the midfield by Sacramento. Nick Ross hanging on. Rodrigo Lopez finding Ammon. Ammon's onside. Cicerone cutting underneath. Russell, the turn. Russell trying to find a teammate. It was Jack Gurr making the back post run. Just a bit late arriving. Roro was going central as well.
It's a good idea by Russell Cicerone. Just trying to flash that ball across the goal. Too far ahead of Rodrigo Lopez. And Jack Gurr can't get it at the back post. Too much on it for him. And those are the kind of moves where the Republic, if they can get the ball into the attack quickly, they'll create more chances.
So 45 plus minutes in the books in Sacramento. Memphis. 9-0-1 coming into town with the first road trip of the season, unable to get on the board.
Sacramento looking for a goal themselves. Both teams able to find a few shots, but none on target. What will the second half bring us? More to come. The Modelo Halftime Show, however, is next. The 901, the Republic. It's week four, the USL Championship here in Northern California.
You'll get it, Doug.
When termites show up, so do we. Terminix it.
You've given us a foundation to be proud of. We build on this now. This is it now, Jens. This is us from now on.
We all have goals. But let's be honest. Most of us aren't going to be professional athletes. But if your goal is to finish your degree, we can help. Come to a university that puts your goals first. Bellevue University, your partner in finishing goals.
Yeah, we're running the game.
We're coming in strong.
Take it higher.
Follow up in. Louisville level in the 70th. He puts it in. Indy 11 leads on the road.
Yeah, we want to take it higher.
Looks great. Oh.
When termites show up, so do we. Terminix it.
It's halftime in Sacramento. No score between the 901 and the Republic. Adam Buffett, Rob McAllister with you here on a beautiful spring night in Northern California. Well, Adam, Memphis came out a bit aggressive, a little threatening early on. Things started to settle down. Sacramento started to regain possession just a tad. But no score as we stand 45 minutes in.
No score, no shots on target, which is not what you love watching, but I think it's going to change the second half. I think it's going to open up. Sacramento be a little more aggressive trying to get a goal here at home. We've seen some opportunities, just that final ball has been lacking.
Well, let's take a look. It's our USL, as we go around the league, some of the best highlights of the first couple of weeks here, and especially here in week three.
Upfield from Knutson, and it finds Lopez, stabs it further, Miami into the penalty area, blasted shot, Miami leads, and it's Alan Gavilanes up from League One with his first championship goal.
Pulling the jersey as this comes in. The header, oh, what a save! Javier Garcia at full stretch keeps this a 1-0 game.
Much more to come here. Modelo at the break. Sacramento, Memphis, week four in the USL Championship. Highlights and upcoming schedule right around the corner.
Sky River Casino, join today and receive $15 in free play. Take your loyalty to new heights with rewards that add up and up. Sky's the limit at Sky River Casino. Join today at skyriver.com.
At Raising Cane's, we focus on being the best at one thing and getting it right every time, which is why every chicken finger meal we serve is marinated, hand battered, cooked to order, and made just for you. Quality isn't complicated, and our menu is proof.
Raising Cane's chicken fingers, one love.
Skip the line and order with our app or online.
If we can bring new life into the world, why can't we bring new hope to those who need it most? If we can remove cancer, why can't we remove hunger? If we can rebuild bodies, why can't we rebuild entire communities? Better health takes more than healthcare. UC Davis Health. Believe in better.
Are you ready to join the charge and put down the pump? If you're ready for a clean start, contact Smut first. We'll help you find ways to save, share the best options to charge at home or on the go, and answer any questions you have about owning an electric vehicle. For everything you need to know about buying, charging, saving, and low rates, start here. Contact Smud first at smud.org/driveelectric.
At Sky River Casino, experience the height of hospitality. With 18 restaurants and bars, there's something for everyone. It's taste on a whole new level. Sky's the limit at Sky River Casino. Join today at skyriver.com.
Crowd taking a break, quenching the thirst. Sacramento Republic, Memphis 901 locks at a scoreless draw. Right here we are in week number four. Let's take a look, however, around the USL as some exciting news already coming up for the league, as there's some big time games going to be happening on the broadcast. And let's take a look as we have some big games. Louisville City, of course, a perennial top team in the league, as they will be taking on Indy 11, as that will be on CBS next Saturday, April 6th at 4 o'clock. And then USL announcing a new team, upstate New York.
Buffalo, great wings out there. That's going to be, it's always fun to see these new teams, new clubs coming in. And Louisville City, the only team so far in the league. I think Tulsa has only played one game, so they won that one. But Louisville 3-for-3 so far on 9 points, so that's a fun game. And congrats, Player of the Week, Alan Gavilanis.
Meanwhile, taking a look at our national broadcast schedule, the Alonzo Network, Detroit City. How about Detroit? Coming out strong already this season, and they've earned a spot. They will be featured on May 11th, but you can see Lou City, Monterey Bay getting a look as well, but a fairly balanced 2024 season in terms of talent. Who will rise to the top, who will perform and end up with results? Well, fine, we had a long way to go. As you take a look at kind of what's coming ahead in terms of some of the bigger games in the league, anyone that maybe early on has surprised you, or is it business as usual for teams like San Antonio and others?
I think the reigning champions, Phoenix Rising, they surprised me a little bit. They're struggling.
The wrong way.
And then,
yeah.
Yes, and then another side, you have Pittsburgh as well, really struggling as well. So in terms of who's doing really well, I think Lou City center, 3 wins from 3 is a big deal.
Well, we've got more to come here at Modelo at the break in Sacramento. It's a scoreless draw. We'll have your highlights, your stats, and much more coming up. And then look at the second half underway here from Hart Health Park.
If we can bring new life into the world, why can't we bring new hope to those who need it most? If we can remove cancer, why can't we remove hunger? If we can rebuild bodies, why can't we rebuild entire communities? Better health takes more than healthcare. UC Davis Health. Believe in better.
How do you build a community that thrives? By staying active, by working and playing together, and by building strong bones and bodies with food that's simple, local, and fresh. Crystal Creamery has proudly supported Central Valley athletes and athletic programs since 2012, because when you nourish a community, the community thrives. Crystal Creamery. Simple, local, fresh.
Are you ready to join the charge and put down the pump? If you're ready for a clean start, contact Smut first. We'll help you find ways to save, share the best options to charge at home or on the go, and answer any questions you have about owning an electric vehicle. For everything you need to know about buying, charging, saving, and low rates, start here. Contact Smud first at smud.org/driveelectric.
At Raising Cane's, we focus on being the best at one thing and getting it right every time. Which is why every chicken finger meal we serve is marinated, hand-battered, cooked to order, and made just for you. Quality isn't complicated, and our menu is proof.
Raising Cane's Chicken Fingers, one love.
Skip the line and order with our app or online.
At Sky River Casino, join today and receive $15 in free play. Take your loyalty to new heights with rewards that add up and up. Sky's the limit at Sky River Casino. Join today at skyriver.com. At Sky River Casino, experience the height of hospitality. With 18 restaurants and bars, there's something for everyone. It's taste on a whole new level. Sky's the limit at Sky River Casino. Join today at skyriver.com.
Welcome back inside Heart Health Park. Rob McAllister, Adam Moffitt with you at the break. Sacramento taking on Memphis 9-1 in week four. And so far in the first half, Adam, this is a team that we weren't quite sure we'd see with two key pieces out in the starting 11, but 9-1 came out and really brought it to Sacramento in those first 10 minutes.
It's been an impressive performance on the road, first road game of the season for Memphis. But Sacramento have looked dangerous from set pieces. This one well rehearsed between Jack Gurr and Rodrigo Lopez, and Gurr just snatching the shot, pulling it wide to the near post.
And to credit for 9-1, they really started to hunker down. They had three really around that six almost the entire time as Sacramento tried to find seams and really unable to do so. Did get several shots off, but just really none on target on Tyler Derrick. But you could see the give and go, spraying it out wide. There were good looks for Sacramento, and this one nearly resulted in a goal for Trevor Ammon.
Almost. It's almost went through his legs, I think, Trevor Ammon. It was. That's what you want to see, though. You want to see the striker make the run in front of the defender. And it's very hard when the ball's played at that pace to get the touch. But it's a fantastic ball by Alder Sanchez. And if Sacramento gets in these positions more in the second half, I think you'll find one of them going in the back of the net.
And how about the crosses from Alder Sanchez tonight? They've really been on point. This time, you see another good look for Sacramento. They're just almost maybe allowing too much time and allowing Memphis to get back.
All those bodies behind there for Memphis, and they'll be happy settling for Nick Ross taking a shot from 25, 30 yards out. It's going to take a lot to beat Tyler Derrick from there, and it might not be Tyler Derrick this second half.
Take a look at our M&S Auto halftime stats. What we talked about against the possession is a well in favor of Sacramento, six shots on the night compared to just Memphis one, but you worried a little bit about the threats that Memphis can bring when you look at a guy like Nico Brett, someone who has scored nearly 90 goals in his USL career.
He's very dangerous. You leave him. And that's where Sacramento has to be careful, is when they have the ball, they have possession of it, and it's that counterattack. Nico Brett, Pickering, Lapa, those guys getting up in the attack. And getting ready for the second half. Republic are ready to go.
No changes in the 11 for Sacramento. Meanwhile, reported was Taylor Bailey at the desk. Meanwhile, did not actually check in. So it looks like Tyler Derrick will continue here in the second half as the goalkeeper for Memphis.
I think Bailey will be ready this second half. It's always tough when you're feeling a sore hamstring, as Tyler Derrick is. You make one bad step, and he feels good enough to continue this second half.
Well, Lucas Turchi was replaced by Marlon Santos, and we'll see whether or not this will become a 3-4-2-1 of sorts for Memphis, or whether or not Marlon Santos will drop back as needed. Typically has played as an attacking mid or forward in his career, and it looks like he'll be a bit further wide, with Leston Paul maybe playing a bit deeper in a support role as a defensive midfielder.
Yeah, I think it'll look like a 3-1-4-2 almost for Memphis. I think we'll see a little bit more of the youngster, Knight Pickering, going up with Nico Brett. That's just going to put a lot of work on Luis Fernando in that left midfielder position. He's got to keep an eye on Jack Gurr, who's always, even though he's a right wing back, he's on the shoulder of that last defender a lot of the time, just looking to break three.
So how does Sacramento attack this sort of new formation we're seeing from Memphis here at the start of the second half?
The way they had success in the first half was getting those wide players involved, and that'll be even, it should be a little easier with a defensive three being narrower. And like I say, it is not Santos or Fernando's most enjoyable aspect of the game is tracking back. So Alder Sanchez, if he can do it both ways, I think you'll see success for Sacramento through Jack Gurr and Alder Sanchez. You're not getting too much from Trevor Ammon through the middle against the likes of Tulu and Sissoko.
Well, for Sacramento, they want to see if they can find Trevor Ammon and Russell Sister, only two guys who are top of shots taken for the first couple of weeks. Meanwhile, you look at Jack Gurr, second in the USL coming into the game with 28 crosses. Meanwhile, tonight, though, you've seen a little bit more of Alder Sanchez in that role and more of a attacking, diving in a little bit for Jack Gurr. And this one's deflected off of Fernando to throw for Sacramento.
These are the positions you spoke about for Sacramento. It's how can they get the ball from the right-hand side here? They have a throw-in. Can they get it? How quickly can they get it out the other way? You see they've done it pretty quickly here, and again they'll try and work it out to the right side now. Every time you do that, you're just moving Memphis side to side, and you're looking for little gaps, little windows to open up, and that was almost one there for Jack Gurr.
Well, you got to make Tyler Derrick, who looks like he might be dealing with a little bit of an injury, get him out running a little bit. That's actually not even a bad result at the end of it, but good idea from Sacramento, trying to move him side to side. Who will score first here tonight? Both teams looking to pick up 3 points. Public coming off a draw with Indy. Memphis after a bye the week before, a 2-1 defeat to Indy. And they meet head to head here for the second time all in the USL Championship. But we'll meet twice here in the Western Conference in 2024. Just bouncing around between the two sides. Rodrigo Lopez trying to shake off a defender. Felipe Cicerone making a move, trying to find Gurr in stride. Gurr's going to wind up. It takes a deflection. Out goes Derek. And it will be a corner kick for Sacramento.
That was well worked by the Republic. And Cicerone does well finding Gurr, but it's just slightly behind him. It slowed him down. At that point, just enough time to get a block on the cross. But they do have a corner kick, the Republic. Well, we've mentioned it last week. They've given up some goals from set pieces. So throughout the season, you don't want to be in the minus there. And they get another chance. This is one we saw in the first half.
Nick Ross, this one floating. Connor Donovan trying to get to it. Trevor Ammon will track it down. And he's run over by Leston Paul.
That's just a silly foul from Leston Paul. Trevor Ammon's going nowhere. And you're just giving a freebie to one of the best set piece takers in the league, if not the best. Giving him another chance to find one of his teammates.
And for Sacramento, the wind has really died down here. And so not much to contend with. Even though not a lot earlier in the game, too, but it was definitely favoring the south end of the field here as they go to the north end bleachers in front of the Tower Bridge Battalion. Republic trying to strike first in week four against the Memphis 901.
You got to get someone running near post.
Back post, Roro punched away by Tyler Derrick. And it will filter out of play.
Republic.
Luis Felipe. Looking for Ammon. Roro trying to get a step. Out comes Tyler Derrick. The new era of USL kicks off in April. Join us Saturday, April 6th on CBS as Louisville City taking on Indy 11, 4 o'clock Eastern at Lynn Family Stadium in Louisville, kicking off the first ever national broadcast of the USL on the CBS networks. Santos, who came into substitution late in the first. Lapa, in play it comes. Duncan, here comes the cross, away it goes. Here comes Memphis, denied again by Sacramento. And offside is.
It might have been offside. Could have been a handball there on Pickering. Just extended at the back post. We'll get a better look at it. That was a dangerous chance, though, for Memphis. Zach Duncan whips that across.
You're right on the left arm there as he's trying to bring it down. Seemed like a great chance for Memphis. Unable. Both teams coming out of the second half here. Looking for a look. There's a turnover to Nico Brett. Connor Donovan is back. Nico Brett nearly finds the upper corner, and it's last touched by Connor Donovan, says Angelio Aragon. And a Memphis 901 player is on the turf after colliding with Rodrigo Lopez.
Aurora took a heavy touch, and he's just checking on him right now. Just making sure Lapa's okay. But that's
what we talked about just coming out of the gate. Nico Brett, can he find a step? And Rodrigo Lopez will earn a booking. Meanwhile, here is the quick turn for Memphis 901. It's so good to using his body as Nico Brett trying to find a goal scoring opportunity there. But Rodrigo Lopez.
And the referee's given a corner kick. I'm not sure if Connor Donovan does block this here, or if he's just sliced across it. Either way, it is a corner kick. And it's another opportunity for Memphis to try and get on the score sheet.
Two yellow cards for each club now. Ball service, back post. Nicely done by Luis Felipe. Santos. Sanchez lets it for Desmond. Lee Desmond made a home for himself in the left center back position, but many injuries a season ago. Mark Briggs used him in a variety of different roles late in the year. This one's to Jack Gurr in the corner. Gurr's going to turn. Here comes the cross, looking for Ammon. It's still up in the air. Ammon trying to give it one more chance at it as Russell Cicerone was waiting in the back of the six. Just a turnover there by Knight Pickering.
Cicerone did a good job getting the ball back for his side. I want to see a lot more from him in the attack, and he's going to get a free kick here. That is.
Angelio Aragon is telling Marlon Santos it's time to calm down. Meanwhile, Leston Paul is having a conversation. Seems like both sides have been a bit upset the way this match has been called, but either way, he's trying to settle things down.
And they're trying to make the claim that he got the ball. He does come away with the ball, but he goes right through the back of Russell Cicerone to get it.
Man, he definitely hits him before he hits the ball.
Not a car crash there. Just about, you're allowed to do whatever you want, but you will get a foul against you.
There are consequences, and there is a booking.
He was Pickering. I'm not sure what he.
Maybe a little dissent. They're trying to clean it up this year.
And if we get a wider look at this free kick from Rodrigo Loca, there's a massive, massive space if someone wants to make a run.
Third yellow card for Memphis on the evening. No score in Sacramento. Rodrigo Lopez, Tyler Derrick trying to move Nico Brett, which always can be dangerous on a counter if Sacramento commits too many forwards. Sanchez will hang out just behind the ball. Nick Ross will shade a bit closer. Cicerone moving, as is Donovan. Back post it comes, crashing comes Sacramento. It's cleared by Tulu. And Aldair Sanchez sees a charging Nico Brett. Memphis going to commit some bodies forward here. As Lapa now, and Sacramento put this all the way back and turns it over. A bad possession there for Sacramento. Well, join us back here at Hart Health Park on Saturday, April 13th. The Indomitable Club taking on FC Tulsa. Kickoff set for 7 o'clock. Tickets are available at SacRepublicFC.com. I think the Republic would like to see Trevor Ammon get a few more touches here, especially in that final third.
Yeah, Trevor and Russell Cicerone. We see Russell, he's switched over to the right now.
And a foul on Luis Fernando.
And it is very hard when you're playing against a team like Memphis now, especially when they're, you know, we said they've gone three at the back. It is a five when they don't have the ball, and that's...
Marlon Santos maybe caught between two minds there, a direct ball, and now Republic have a corner kick.
Tyler Derricks, just tell him, just chest it back in my hands.
An Atlas disposal corner kick coming for Sacramento on the 57th. Sanchez will hover. It'll be Lopez to take it. In swinging ball here, back post, sails over. Lee Desmond wasn't sure if there was a teammate making a run. And a rare errant ball by number 8. So a goal kick for Tyler Derrick. Meanwhile, Sacramento might want to see Cicerone and Ammon get involved. On the other end, it's Brett and Pickering. Pickering coming off a national call-up. He's been an FC Dallas Academy player before coming to Memphis. But a young player, U19 call-up, and he's really starting to build a resume and trying to become the guy and maybe a leading scorer in Memphis here in 2024.
And Stephen Glass this week spoke about Pickering, and it looks like he can score every game, and that's what you want to see from a young player, and he wants to score every game, is that hunger. We haven't seen too much of him tonight, but he's still involved in the action, and he's got a bright future ahead of him. He keeps up the hard work.
I mentioned he loved the experience, and usually these guys get a bit of a boost. This ball's coming behind Republic, and it'll be Connor Donovan to track it down. He's going to send it upfield. Maybe spring Cicerone or somebody forward. Is Fernando trying to play it? And Cicerone and Fernando coming together. And it trickles out of play. Is that Nick Ross? It was Nick Ross, excuse me. Cicerone running on the inside. No Keem Ward, no Oscar Jimenez, both issued red cards in the loss to Indy 2 weeks ago. Sacramento now, a little bit of pressure. We have not seen a lot of the press from Sacramento. Maybe just haven't had the ability to do so. Both teams have escaped a bit of pressure and a bit shaky at times, but neither side has really tested the other goalkeeper. Rodrigo Lopez, and he has brought down. Duncan already working on a yellow. And you can see Oliver Marquand saying, I remember.
Was that without the hands
guess,
of either
to the men,
or use your head?
Or use your head? I'm thinking about
it. I don't know. Whatever it is, it's
I'm thinking about
falling.
You.
Yes.
I don't know.
No more fouls for you. I said, remember Turchi?
Remember Turchi. Ammon coming together.
And we're getting to that stage in the game. It's coming in at the 59th minute. It's usually 60th minute is when you see coaches thinking about making a substitution, giving someone 30 minutes to try and make an impact. And I think this game is calling out for someone to come in and maybe change the energy a little bit. Well, neither side looking like they're going to score at the moment.
Well, for Memphis, too, you might think about, well, we're on the road. We don't have a deep bench. Do you sit back a little bit and maybe just try to earn a point on the road? A lot of things to think about for both of these coaches. You know, Sacramento, they want to try to find their first win at home, just a second game, and there's a collision there. Just slowing things up. There's Jared Timmer. Timmer, really an Ironman his season ago. 35 appearances, 33 starts for the Sacramento Republic. And now some cramping taking place 60 minutes in. two 901 players on the turf. That cannot be a good sign for Stephen Glass.
You know, one of them.
I don't think they're trying to eat time away. There's still 30 minutes to go here.
No, and one of them, Sissoko, we saw him less than Paul, and then Sissoko's the other. We saw him taking a break for Ramadan, just getting some nutrients in his body. Obviously observing that. It is, I've played with a lot of teammates who did observe that, and you know, their body does need a lot. So as soon as that sunset, I'm glad they took that break and got some in them, but your muscles are still feeling that. He's probably put 5-6 miles on his body already tonight.
Especially earlier in the season too, where you're not fully fit. Rodrigo Lopez, a little bit of a tap, but nobody joining him. Trying to play over the top, staying onside. And we'll see this one. It'll go to Memphis. It will be a throw-in. And here's a guy who's been key off the bench, Jonathan Ricketts. He's typically coming in more of a striker position, but he's going to come in for Luis Felipe, maybe a little bit more of what Ricketts is used to throughout his career. Came over from RGV a season ago. We had 3 goals and 2 assists. Mark Briggs called him their most athletic player. And Luis Felipe dealt with a little bit of injury in preseason. They're still limiting his minutes. And so now Ricketts comes into the match, the first substitution for Sacramento, and Marlon Santos, this ball slipped out of his hand and it flew right behind him. They'll give him a redo.
Those Brazilians have got some tricks, right?
Well, Sacramento just takes it away as Rodrigo Lopez playing this one up the pitch. Paul, he'll deal with Trevor Ammon. Tulu, able to escape Vom Stieg. Vom Stieg coming over from Loudoun United before joining Memphis in 2023. This one's to Santos. Santos making a cross down low. Jared Timmer shuffling the feet, sending it away, keeping Nico Brett away from the attack.
Good piece of defending by Jared Timmer.
Another throw for Memphis.
And we'll see if Marlon Santos is going to get this one in play. He does.
Ammon just plays this one. Cicerone, teammate moving is Ricketts, and Cicerone just could not get one more touch on that, and Jonathan Ricketts was running right down the spine of the field.
And I'm not sure if Ricketts let him know, and sometimes it can be tough to make sure you're heard, but he's got to be screaming for that first time from Russell Cicerone. He's through on goal if he does, and Russell has that ability, whether it be the left foot or the outside of his right, he can find them. I'm just not too sure he was aware of him.
Connor Donovan, the U.S. All League first team. Jack Kerr keeping this ball in play. Ricketts. Floated into the corner from Rodrigo Lopez. Good service in. This one's down low. Able to get to it is Tulu. And now the counter springing forward, trying to get Pickering. It's a foot race with Lee Desmond, and a whistle and a yellow card as Connor Donovan maybe committed a foul way back in Memphis's half here. And another booking issued. That's the sixth of the night, each team with three.
Connor Donovan, he was right in behind Nico Brett. It was a lovely touch by Brett, just flicking around the corner for Pickering. And we were all fixated on the race between Desmond and Pickering, but there's not much in it, to be honest. I mean, he gets a yellow card for it, but
that was good to see.
Nico Brett was one a little break there.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, just a healthy Lee Desmond able to track back and get in front of that ball. Stepping in is Duncan. Plays it central. Pickering is the target. Vidiello and Trevor Ammon is clipped in the back, and Vom Stieg will now receive a booking. It's a bit chippy out here tonight. I mean, might be soft at times, but I'll tell you what, it feels like there's a narrative now that has taken place, and both teams are going to be on watch here. as the yellow cards start to pile up, number 7 on the night. And there's two substitutions, meanwhile, likely to be made here by Stephen Glass in Memphis, 901.
And these are always tricky ones. When a player's backing up, no real awareness what's behind them. Vom Steek just comes through the back of Trevor Ammon, takes his yellow card, no real complaints on his end.
And here comes substitutions. Dylan Borsak will come into the game for Nico Brett. Borsak, a former teammate of Jonathan Ricketts. And then Samuel Carriaga also coming into the match for Memphis, 9-1.
And Sissoko, he's had a really good night. We just mentioned, though, just cramping up, and you don't want one of your back three locking up as he's chasing someone down. With 25 minutes to go, it's the right choice, and Sissoko goes off the other side of the field. They're not just throwing an extra player on. If you're watching on TV, you think he's just, got 12th guy on there.
So A.B. Sissoko out. Samuel Carriaga into the game. The Argentinian has a goal on the season. Just 7 matches with this club a year ago. Might be asked to play a more dangerous role in 2024. And they're going to likely need him with some of the departures they had in the offseason. Sava is a tuition-free 7th through 12th grade public charter school. Choose from career pathways, including patient health care. You can even earn college credit at savacharterschool.org. Meanwhile, the collision, crowd not liking it. And Laudair Sanchez slow to get up.
Santos was the one who caught him. In Memphis right now, they've got Zach Duncan's going to fill in as that central defender in between Tulu and Vom Steeg. Not his most natural position, but he's a versatile player. We've seen it so far.
Ammon trying to head it back to Cicerone. The flag was up as he was offside. And with that, we'll step aside.
With Smud Rebates, you'll save big. Save money and save the planet for generations to come. Get rebates up to $3,500 from Smud on clean power appliances, electric vehicles, and much more at cleanpowercity.org.
Sanchez popping this ball forward. Trevor Ammon trying to make a run on it. Cicerone is there. Lapa, a step in, a foul on Lee Desmond. Republic 5 points, Memphis with 3, both in the Western Conference. And as you look at scores around the league, San Antonio taking down Memphis, taking down Monterey Bay, 2-1. Borsak battling with Connor Donovan. Aldair Sanchez, last touch. It will be a throw for Memphis. 3-0 Vegas, currently in the 73rd minute over Oakland. And Orange County has a goal lead over Tulsa. Deep throw into the box it goes. Donovan to Sanchez. Memphis has had a little bit of better of the possession here currently.
It's been a really, you would have told Stephen Glass here at the 70th minute, you're still 0-0. You've had to take a player out because you're worried they're going to get red carded. You've had a few injuries, goalkeeper. I think he'd be happy with where he's at. His team's still in this game. There's still a good chance for Memphis to go on the road in their first ever game being in the Western Conference and potentially take home 3 points.
Meanwhile, for Sacramento, you can kind of feel they're just not quite on the same page. They can't find their rhythm here. I don't know if it's self-inflicted, if it's just the way that Memphis has been able to defend them tonight. But you felt like they've been much more dominant in the first 3 weeks. But as you know, things can turn quickly for either one of these teams. Early on in the year, all points matter. It will be Bruno Lapa. Lapa delivering this ball, looking pretty good for Memphis. And Nick Ross
Foul called in there. Referee saw something. It was well defended by Jack Gurr. Regardless. But just Sacramento failing to get much of a rhythm. And we spoke to Mark Briggs about, you know, the chemistry and the attacking. Obviously, Sebastian Herrera is out right now. But Trevor Ammon, Russell Cicerone, Ricketts is in there. Roro, just continuing to gel. The more games they can get, they'll get on the same page. That ball was still in play. That's a nice ball from Cicerone.
Here's the move up. Look at this ball coming from Roro. It's hurt. Jack Gurr. Gurr with a snap. Gurr's denied by Tyler Derrick. Oh, what a stop from the former MLS man. Republic, a full head of steam. You felt like the whole crowd was just ready to erupt. Meanwhile, another booking is shown against Memphis. And this time, it's against Carriaga. But what a ball coming from Rodrigo Lopez. Just a big-time stop from Tyler Derrick.
Big-time from Tyler Derrick. But what a pass from Rodrigo Lopez. We mentioned Jack Gurr just on the shoulders of the defenders. He was in the right spot, did everything right. And Tyler Derrick made himself as big as possible. And things are getting a little bit bordering on, getting a bit,
bit
too
chippy.
Much here.
Cicerone trying to see if he can draw a foul on Luis Fernando.
And you've got to use that if you're Sacramento. The fans are back in the game. You've got to keep this pressure up. You've got 20 minutes left in the game. Remember being in these situations, sometimes the game's in a bit of a lull, and it just takes one moment. And it might have been that pass from Roro.
Lopez drawing this one well. It was Ricketts. Ball still flying all around. Is Timmer trying to put it back in? Look at this from Cicerone. Oh, out comes Derrick to make a play and slaps it to a teammate. Another great stop. Trevor Ammon was right in the hunt. Cicerone battling a whistle and now a yellow. Carriaga.
And he's throwing his arms up, Carriaga, but you'll get another look at this. He's jumped in with 2 feet. He's got the ball. We know that. But there's absolutely no need to do that.
So Carriaga, another 901 player to receive a booking. I think it's number 7. I may have lost count so far.
Yeah, that's a lot. And again, the referee just didn't like the manner in which Carriaga just jumped at that ball there. And he gets the ball and he can make a claim that he did. But this is another chance here for Roro.
Cicerone trying to peel off front post. Roro's going to wait for it. Ball coming in.
And it goes through everyone. That's just begging for someone to get around that back stick. Put it back across the goal, and Tyler Derrick's talking to his teammates. He really needs, them to put everything they have into this last 15, 20 minutes.
Well, they were able to escape this recent spell by Sacramento, and nearly fantastic goal coming from the Republic. Rodrigo Lopez finding Jack Gurr, just a big time stop coming from Tyler Derrick. Still 15 to so to go. Scoreless and a foul coming in against Memphis. Memphis, first 5 of 7 are going to be in Tennessee. So they know they're going to get up to a hot start because it's going to be a tough couple of stretches for them. Cicerone takes it off the right heel. We'll look to serve this one in. The run's coming. Back is Ammon. Nick Ross finding a teammate. Well done. It's the small things in games like this can ultimately prove to be a game winner. Alder Sanchez. In comes Lee Desmond. Roro is going to cut back. Roro's got room. He's got Lee Desmond, the left foot, and it's off of the head of Santos.
Well done, Santos. And Sacramento definitely have upped things in the last few minutes. I think it was that one play where Roro fed it through to Jack Gurr. Tyler Derrick comes up with a massive stop, but since then, you can feel the players have got a lot more energy.
Well, you're right. They've got the crowd here as well. Ball driven well, bouncing around Sacramento. Here's Gurr. It takes off the back of Dylan Borsak. Another corner kick for Sacramento. Memphis just hanging on right now.
And every single player from Memphis is inside the box. So even if they clear it, it's coming straight back at them.
Derek Ayer, the punch away. And a couple of Republic players may have collided on that possession.
So Donovan and Desmond, the two players down for Sacramento. Lee's back up.
Both charging hard to try to find a piece of it. Yeah, it looks like when Tyler Derrick came out, maybe
he just went through everyone. I'm not sure if they made contact with each other or Tyler Derrick just came through them. Tyler, the train Derrick.
Derrick, a big time stop a few minutes ago to keep this game scoreless in Northern California. The first of two. The next time these sides meet will be in Tennessee on October 12th, toward the end of the year. Meanwhile, the Tower Bridge Battalion having a few words with Tyler Derrick. He's having a conversation back. I'm sure as a goalkeeper, while it's a bit annoying, you also probably love it just a tad to have an atmosphere like this.
Yeah, you feed off that. Any player coming into Sacramento, they love playing in front of this fan base, even though they're booing them, they're not rooting for them. You just appreciate that as a player, that you're in this kind of atmosphere. Lee Desmond, Connor Donovan, good to continue. Sometimes the little breaks in the play can slow down the momentum. And I think it's important to senior players, Nick Ross, Rodrigo Lopez, just keep it up, make sure everyone's still going for it. There's not too much experience on the bench for Sacramento. You have Dami Vieder, good to see him back on the bench. Christian Pirano can make a difference.
How about Ricketts just shrugging off the Memphis 901 and then he gets run under. Donovan and Derrick playing together in Houston back in 2018. Sacramento fans, they can feel it. Can the Republic deliver? If anybody on this roster can, it should be number 8. Had a few words with Connor Donovan here. They're going to try to set something up. Sacramento would love to see one of their big men get a goal.
And a lot of these balls have been going around that back post. So you got to just make sure you have someone a little deeper.
Little right down the middle this time. Gurr's winding up. Gurr's coming through. And it's Memphis again. Headed back in by Ross. But now the breakaway from Memphis. Trying to make something happen. Alder Sanchez selling out. Able to get a piece on it. But Fernando still charging forward. Pickering making the run, as is Borsak. Borsak gets through, back heel. Here comes Nine, it's denied! Danny Vidiello with Bruno Lapa nearly got the go-ahead goal here late in this one. What a stop, both keepers coming up massive here tonight.
Massive moment from Danny Vidiello, and what a goal this would have been by Memphis on the break. Borsak flipping it back, and Lapa just... Unfortunately for him, he just can't put it either side of Vitiello. It would have been a 1-0 Memphis lead.
An Atlas Despoca corner kick coming for the 901. Meanwhile, changes for Mark Briggs' side.
And that's what you need, Vitiello. He barely had anything to do. That's his first save of the game. And you just got to always be ready for that goalkeeper.
The last 10 minutes delivering some drama here in Sacramento. Trying to wind back up, takes the deflection away, and another corner kick for Memphis. Bruno Lapa nearly finding his first on the year. Had 5 goals a season ago. Memphis was able to withstand the momentum by Sacramento. Now they'll try to turn the tables. Nice clearance from Trevor Ammon. And Cicerone and Ammon will provide some pressure as Memphis trying to get one back in. Rodrigo Lopez battling with Borshak, and he's able to draw the foul. A crafty move by the veteran. And here we have some substitutions for Sacramento. Is Dami Vieder, after a couple of weeks on the inactive list, is back into the mix as Russell Cicerone will come out of the game.
We've seen Rafa Arrighi the last few weeks. Should have had an assist last week. Trevor Ammon just failed to put it in the back of the net. And then the week prior, he got a goal when he came in and judged to be offside.
Brutal.
The replays show that he was not offside.
And if you look at what Rafa has done, he has stepped up, had a fantastic preseason, and really should have a goal and assist here in 2024 already. Comes in as a substitute trying to make an impact. Here he is breaking free. He's got fresh legs. There's an opportunity now on this left side with Dami Vieder. Very good on 1v1 situations. Could open up something in the middle.
And this would be a huge moment for him. As a youngster coming into the game, can he take that next step? I think a lot of the time with Rafa, it's, you know, being so young, each game he's getting experience now with a great preseason under his belt. Can he translate that into the regular season?
Roro trying to float it up over the top. Rafa able to come back and stay on his feet. Nicely done by Sacramento to win it back. Lee Desmond will peel away. Nick Ross looking to switch the field potentially here. Memphis has done a fairly decent job of staying compact. Ricketts gets a step. He'll take it off the chest. Tulu. Here's Gurr, a little bit of a heavy touch, but trying to find a teammate. Comes it back to Ricketts. It's stuffed out by Memphis, and Borshak now looking to go the other way. Pickering being pressured by the center back, Connor Donovan. And Republic now, and a late whistle. And the crowd on the far end.
And Borjak's done really, really well coming into this game. We saw him a couple years back at RGV, and he's just got good energy to him. And that's what he's brought into this game. Almost had that assist for Bruno Lapa. If it weren't for Danny Vitiello coming up massive.
No score, 83 minutes gone by here in Sacramento, and a foul on Borshak. Sacramento will travel to Colorado Springs, while Memphis will host Orange County. Coming up next Saturday, early start for the Republic here on the West Coast, 5 o'clock local kick. Here's a direct ball. Pickering coming opportunity. It's Ricketts. Pickering nearly got a toe on it as that ball was sent right past him. And Ricketts made a heck of a run. Or was that Ammon on the other end?
Jack Gurr who's coming in, and once again it was Jack Rodrigo Lopez looking for Jack Gurr. And Tyler Derrick was right on the edge of his box, but this is Trevor Ammon this time.
Ammon trying to cut it back. Ricketts. And now this game has really been whistle tight.
And again, and Leston Paul's cramping up again. That's twice now. To be fair to him, 20 minutes ago he was cramping up initially, so he's done well. And Trevor Ammon just mishit that. He got a really good position on that right hand side. Tried to play the ball across the face and mishit it. Almost works out into the path of Jonathan Ricketts.
Well, we've had
lots of tired legs out there, so this last 5+ stoppage time is going to be interesting. I think
a lot of the yellow
we'll
cards
see a couple
issued.
Chances yeah. as well, yeah.
Both teams, goalkeepers with massive saves. In the 70th minutes. Ricketts really has come on and had a nice give it a go. This is a battle here. Ammon working against Duncan. Rodrigo Lopez trying to play to Rafa. Rafa finding Trevor Ammon, and Ammon is taken down just beyond the corner, and Rodrigo Lopez will help up his teammate. And will this be the golden chance for the home side? And Duncan, who had an early yellow card, the first of the game, is given his final warning. And another use your head signal coming from Elio Aragon. You ever been lectured like that by a referee? I'm sure you have.
Yeah.
I mean.
Yeah, I have. And you just feel like it's just a matter of time with these the amount of set pieces Sacramento has had. Someone gets on the end of something.
It's Rodrigo Lopez, one of the all-time greats here in the capital of California in any sport. Can he deliver one here in week number four? Ricketts battles in, yeah! Goal, Sacramento! Jonathan Ricketts, his first in a Republic uniform. Bounced around, took a couple of hops, wasn't sure it went through. Tyler Derrick couldn't keep it out, and it's 1-0 Sacramento here late. Almost the exact moment it happened a year ago in July against this very Memphis team. This time it's Ricketts, his first. It's got to feel good there, Adam.
And it came from a set piece. We felt like it was just a matter of time until someone got an end of it, and that someone was Jonathan Ricketts, and I don't know how much he knew about it. Ends up coming off his chest, and it's the follow-up. Tyler Derrick, another great save. And Jonathan Ricketts with his left foot just taps it into the net, and a little slice of fortune for the Republic, but they do not care. They kept at it, and they've got the reward. Now they get 3 minutes plus stoppage time to see out this game.
Meanwhile, Christian Pirano will come into this match, and he'll replace Trevor Ammon. So Pirano, questionable whether he would be in this game or even in the 18, has come in late now as a substitution. It appears to be okay. Had a good training on Friday, and the coaching staff felt that he was ready to go. The Republic got to close this one out. We saw what happened against Orange County in week one at the death. Colin Shuttler on a set piece, able to score. And with 2-2 level.
And that free kick initially happened. We spoke about the tired legs. Tulu missed the ball. And then he puts his teammate Zach Duncan in a tough spot. Makes a foul, and Rodrigo Lopez, magnificent delivery, just putting the ball in the right spot.
Zachary Duncan will be replaced by Noah Mesa out of Washington. 23 goals, 6 assists the last two seasons with Union Omaha. And so Stephen Glass going to see if they can salvage at least a point here on the road, trying to avoid back-to-back defeats. Gurr. And last touch by Memphis as this one is sent into the crowd. Jonathan Ricketts, 3 goals a season ago, but his first in a Republic uniform that comes at home, and a potential game winner. Just stayed with it. What a delivery from Rodrigo Lopez. Unfortunately won't get the assist because the denial from Tyler Derrick, who came up with 2 big saves tonight, but unable to stop that second effort by Jonathan Ricketts, and that's the difference here.
And it's been such a resilient performance from Memphis. It's always a tough thing when you put in such a shift, and they really have to give up a late goal. And their time's running out to get anything from this game.
Jack Gurr comes in strong, and there will be another booking against Memphis as Jack Gurr came in to clear that away. Coming in hard, who just came into the game, is Mesa. And so another yellow. And that is the 7th yellow card against Memphis.
Too sure on that one. He came in hard again, but didn't get a good, clear enough look on that. But anyway, what? Another yellow. I'm not sure.
I want to go back to what we saw from Tyler Derrick as we have 6 minutes of stoppage time officially here. Tyler Derrick makes a massive save, and just about 4 or 5 minutes later, Danny Vidiello once again comes up with a massive stop. Rafa Hadagi, meanwhile, trying to keep this alive for the Republic, and does. Over the top, floating. Here's Gurr trying to settle it in the corner. Rafa, nicely done. Perfect timing as Republic try to eat this away. We saw the massive stops that Danny Vidiello made in Miami to preserve a win. That one over there may be just the biggest stop he's made in quite some time. And he's made some fantastic saves here in the Sacramento uniform.
He really has. And I think last year, obviously, getting the Golden Glove, I think a lot of being on a team is very good defensively. You don't get challenged as much as some of these other goalkeepers. So we might not have seen as many amazing saves, but so far this season, he's saving points for this team.
And nor do we want to, right?
Yeah, you'd rather not every week expect the goalkeeper, you know, get save of the week. You don't really want that, but he's been great.
A little back heel from Santos, finding Lapa.
This
Lapa
isn't done. There's 6 minutes of added time.
And Lapa was the man who nearly had that first goal for Memphis. Domi Villanueva crossing this ball in. He's got Ricketts. Ricketts trying to take a touch first. And able to recover was Luis Fernando. Sacramento fans just wanted to put that in the corner and eat it off. But, man, he kind of felt there was just a golden opportunity for Ricketts to put this game away for good. And this is a bad pick from Derrick, who had been dealing with a right hamstring earlier in the game. And even without that, he's really didn't seem effective until probably then. So Jonathan Ricketts out of Chattanooga, Tennessee, coming up big. 26-year-old, signed in the offseason. And with how good this Republic team was in 2023, 4 weeks in, it's two new guys who have all your goals. Got to feel pretty good about who you've picked up in the offseason if you're Sacramento. Tulu sends it out of play. Bob looking to just eat this clock up, and it will be a goal kick. Sacramento felt it was last off a Memphis player. Meanwhile, the 901 trying to hurry with less than 3 minutes to go. Step here, a hard challenge, and a booking will be issued to Domi Vidiello. Nope, he goes away from the puck. It looked like it was going to be a quick one for Domi Vidiello.
You just typecast the referee here. The yellow card guy.
I've also just been preconditioned now at this point.
I'll be surprised. I thought he was getting one. Well, Sacramento don't want to give up here. Is a set piece.
It'll be a throw as Donovan was able to get ahead to it.
Carriaga has a long throw on him. Fake out, goes short with it.
Rafa doing the small things. It's going to how he'll find himself with more minutes, but he has been impressive every time he's come in. This ball served well for Memphis. Cleared away, but not out of trouble yet as Sacramento. Here comes the cross again. Ricketts, the man who has the game-winning goal so far, but Memphis trying to tie it up late. Rafa will just send this down the field.
Tyler Derrick takes the throw in.
Paul climbing the ladder is Timmer. Pirano, so good. Shifty one-on-one play, as is this man, number three, Domi Villanueva. They can really dribble you into a bit of dizziness. Lee Desmond will try to play it forward and does to Pirano. and broken up. Rafa trying to get a step. Right back to Memphis it comes, about a minute or so less to go.
Aroro still going. Whole game for him.
Timmer.
What an out for the captain of Sacramento.
Plays it forward, Ricketts has a step. Out comes Derek as it trickles into his 18.
And this is last chance saloon here for Memphis. You gotta get this ball forward.
Republic are gonna try to meet him at the point of attack. Santos, the 28-year-old, battling. And no whistle. Rodrigo Lopez, Pirano.
Rafa can get something here. Pirano finds
him. Look at Pirano staying on his feet, trying to close this game out. Pirano will take a shot at goal, and Derek gonna put it in the corner, kill the game. Oh man, hopefully that doesn't come back to haunt Sacramento. I know you want to get a good crack at it, but this might be one last chance for Memphis. Memphis will drill this ball forward, and I think Vidiello can just see this one out. It will be a goal kick and likely the last play of tonight. And that's the final whistle. Home crowd celebrates. Jonathan Ricketts signed in the offseason from RGV. And the Tennessee man going against the Tennessee club, able to find a game winner. Republic win 1-0 in our Western Health Advantage. Man of the match is Jonathan Ricketts.
Good for him getting that first goal in a Republic jersey. And initially it looked like he didn't know much about the first chance. He put himself in a great position, but great heads up play, just following up, getting the left foot on that second one. And he is your Western Health Advantage man of the match. And
a big time save for that man as well. Danny Vidiello and the Republic walking away with 3 points, 8 on the season. They go to 2 wins, no losses, and 2 draws. Memphis falls to 1-2 on the year. We'll be back with a final postgame show coming up next.
At Sky River Casino, join today and receive $15 in free play. Take your loyalty to new heights with rewards that add up and up. Sky's the limit at Sky River Casino. Join today at skyriver.com.
How do you build a community that thrives? By staying active, by working and playing together, and by building strong bones and bodies with food that's simple, local, and fresh. Crystal Creamery has proudly supported Central Valley athletes and athletic programs since 2012. Because when you nourish a community, the community thrives. Crystal Creamery, simple, local, fresh.
If we can bring new life into the world, why can't we bring new hope to those who need it most? If we can remove cancer, why can't we remove hunger? If we can rebuild bodies, why can't we rebuild entire communities? Better health takes more than healthcare. UC Davis Health, believe in better.
At Raising Cane's, we focus on being the best at one thing and getting it right every time, which is why every chicken finger meal we serve is marinated, hand battered, cooked to order, and made just for you. Quality isn't complicated, and our menu is proof.
Raising Cane's chicken fingers, one love.
Skip the line and order with our app or online.
At Sky River Casino, experience the height of hospitality. With 18 restaurants and bars, there's something for everyone. It's taste on a whole new level. Sky's the limit at Sky River Casino. Join today at skyriver.com.
Mark Briggs in the Republic will take away 3 points from tonight. They battle all night long, never really had maybe their best stuff, but at the end of the day, all I remember is the victory here against the 901. Let's take a look at our full-time highlights. We said early on this could be one of those games that you don't want to fall in a trap to, because Memphis may be a little shorthanded. But they've got some scrappy players. They came out really a good 8 minutes, and this was probably the first real good look from Sacramento. Obviously didn't find target, but you could see maybe Sacramento trying to find some holes early on.
And the set pieces were something we felt Sacramento could have got something from, but there was not much action, and this probably changed the game. I think Rodrigo Lopez, the pass for Jack Kerr. He doesn't score from it. Tyler Derrick, a brilliant piece of goalkeeping.
We might have two contenders for save of the week just in this match alone. And a few minutes later, Sacramento would try to find and hold off, and it would be this time Danny Vidiello with a big time stop.
And that is great reactions from the Golden Glove winner, because either side of them, though, you got to think that's 1-0 Memphis.
And it changes the entire game. Sacramento not to be done. They continue. They draw a foul league. Rodrigo Lopez puts it perfectly. Ricketts gets there and then stays with it. And Derrick cannot hold it. And it's 1-0 late. And Sacramento would go on to win this one. Jonathan Ricketts is first in the Old Glory red kit. And he's got to feel real good about doing that at home here in week number 4. 12 shots for Sacramento, 4 on target, and really Memphis, the one we saw there. And again, Sacramento dominating possession. It seems to be a theme here in 2024.
Yeah, good. We got a lot of the ball. And I think what we saw, no shots on target either side the first half. We saw the massive save from Danny Vitiello. Tyler Derrick made some huge stops, just unfortunately unable to keep away that second effort from Jonathan Ricketts.
So Sacramento going on the road yet again. They'll be heading to Colorado Springs, and that'll be a tough match. Even though this is a club that's starting off a bit slow in the year, it's always a very difficult place to play because of the altitude, and then hosting Tulsa, and then the rematch with Orange County down in Southern California.
Was it a bit sad that we play Orange County twice so early in the season? We won't get to see them again, and because I think that is a team who are going to be there amongst the top
in the
Western Conference.
Yeah, it might be 1-2 in the standings at the end of the season. Well, thank you for tuning in tonight. Hope you have a great Easter weekend. Sacramento picking up the win. Jonathan Ricketts, his first on the season. Want to thank our entire crew here in Sacramento, our producer John Safaro, our entire production team. For Adam Moffitt, I'm Rob McAllister. We'll hope to see you next Saturday as the Republic take on Colorado Springs.
This copyrighted telecast of the United Soccer League Championship cannot be retransmitted, rebroadcast, or reproduced without the expressed written consent of the United Soccer League Championship.